As Congress put the debt bill together, millions of Americans turned to social media to make their voices heard. Molly Wood, executive editor of CNET TV, looks at how social media followed the debt limit debate literally second by second.
Moments before Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords appeared on the House floor to participate in the debt limit vote, Twitter users already knew she was there. As she tweeted, "The Capitol looks beautiful, and I am honored to be at work tonight." It was her first time back at work since she was shot in January, and word of her arrival quickly spread across the internet, showing once again that social media sites like Twitter and Facebook continue to be increasingly important for congressional members to get their message across.
Imagine polling from years ago being instantaneous. That's what social media, Twitter, Facebook allow candidates or congressmen and citizens to do with each other.
Matthew Lira is director of new media for House Majority Leader Eric Cantor. He gave CBS News the first look at how the GOP office monitors, in real time, social media sites.
It's a sea change from, say, 2 years ago, where if you're not following it on Twitter, you're out of the loop and you're behind the curve.
On Friday, even the president asked Americans to join the debate on Twitter, urging his more than 9 million followers to ask their representatives to support a bipartisan solution. Over the next 8 hours, the president's message had spread to 36 million Twitter users as voters vented their frustrations with the debt deadlock.
Obama's trying to use social media to create a 21st century fireside chat. The difference is that when we were sitting at home in the Great Depression, we couldn't talk back to the radio. Now everybody gets to talk back.
Molly Wood for CBS News, San Francisco.